Such a wonderful family, Cedric and Leonard, and Leonard's fiance, Cedric's sister, a nephew Kai that lived next door. We had a wonderful time with them, and we're were just so blessed to experience things with them. We did a lot of work that Gary will tell you about that was very rewarding, and we just had a wonderful trip. Some of the time we were able to venture out on our own, on our free time, and we went to the Lower Ninth Ward, which I'm sure a lot of you saw the pictures on TV of how bad it was. There were people that the water reached the rooftop levels of their homes. It was devastating. We actually had no idea that it would still be that bad in New Orleans, but when we went and drove around there, there were houses maybe on one side of the street that were just beautiful, renovated, perfect, and then right across the street you may see a house that was totally destroyed, or an area where there was not even a house there, just maybe the foundation. It's just so sad because these people have to look at that every day. Even though some have rebuilt, they still are reminded every day when they look at the areas that are still in just such destruction. We had a wonderful trip, and I think we were just all blessed. When they hear someone say,
mostly because the first time we didn't precisely go to New Orleans. We worked in a Cajun community about an hour outside. And again, it's kind of the same feeling as the second trip, that these people have a lot less and can live on a lot less, especially during times of disaster, and it makes you a lot grateful for everything that you have back home. I feel kind of spoiled after each time. But yeah, just helping people, especially in a situation like the family we helped, is a tremendous feeling of just feeling good about your accomplishments and knowing that you help somebody who doesn't have what you have, especially walls and ceilings.
My favorite part out of like the whole trip was just like the teamwork that we had, and like just kind of hanging out together and being together and like all our meals, and you know, praying before our meals. And then it took like a lot of teamwork to get the house together and stuff, and nobody could have done it by themselves, so we all needed each other. And it was pretty fun, like hanging out with each other, like while we weren't working, you know, taking water breaks and stuff, and it just turned out to be real fun, like hanging out.
of water, earth, and sky. The heavens are your tabernacle. Glory to the Lord on high. God of wonders beyond our galaxy. You are holy, holy. The universe declares your majesty.
The family we were assigned to was not affected by the flooding of Katrina, but they were damaged from the winds and all. It blew the roof off their home, and they didn't have insurance, so luckily the government did help them out with relief money. And they hired a contractor to do the work, and he started the work and left out on them, and they didn't, you know, have anything else to do, so they started having to do the work themselves because of the money situation was real bad. And they did some of the work, and the house ended up catching on fire due to the work wasn't done properly. And so we were brought in to hang sheetrock is what we were told to do. And when we got to the job site, it was far from being ready for installation of sheetrock. We had to first go through and prep the house. We probably pulled out hundreds of nails in the walls and in the ceiling. And, you know, due to the fire, we had to reinforce all the studs in the walls and the ceiling system also to be able to install the sheetrock. We started insulating the house with fiberglass insulation in all the walls. And we did get a lot of sheetrock up in most of the rooms and on the ceilings, and actually started preparing for paint. We started finishing the rooms and with mud and sheetrock tape, and got it ready to, I know one room is completely ready to be painted, but we did get all the sheetrock up in almost all the rooms.
You are holy.
Because we didn't really get to see the finished product of the house. For example, when we were in Kentucky, we were able to do a small part of the house that was messed up, fix it, and we would just be really happy and excited about what we got done, and we knew we did a better job. And in New Orleans, like, we fixed some parts of the house, but it was just so messed up from the hurricane and the flooding that we were only able to do a small amount to getting the house back to normal.
Trip, we met Cedric's nephew. His name was Kai, and he happened to live next door. And at first, he wouldn't really come over to see us. He thought about coming over, like he would watch us from his yard and wave at us, and he wanted to come over, but he was kind of scared. And near the, I guess it was the last day, or maybe the day before, he finally came over and wanted to help us work. And it was really cute. He just really wanted to help us in any way that he could. He wanted us to teach him how to do anything that he could possibly help with. So it was really nice to be able to work with him and get him involved in what we were doing. And it was just a really great experience overall. From above, I have been there. No one fear is all about. Yes, I have.
Met some wonderful people, and the family that we were helping, there were several of them, but the two closest ones that we worked with mainly, the names were Leonard and Cedric. Leonard was someone who was very, very, he was involved in what we were doing and wanted to help out with everything concerning building the house, and he was a great help to all of us. And just the conditions that the family lived in, they, like, it was very clear to us that they had a very simple life, and yeah, just kind of encouraged, at least encouraged me to lead a little more simple life in my way. And so, yeah, I think basically the people that we met, and especially Leonard, to me, the way he lived so simply and yet helped out and wanted to help out with making the house and making it part, you know, like his work also, it's really encouraging to all of us.
And I spent a lot of time with Cedric, who was an older gentleman, and all that he liked to do was sit on the front porch. Sometimes he would move his chair down into the yard, and sometimes to the other side of the yard, and then back up to the porch. That was pretty much how he spent his days, but he was very fun. And he was really excited one day when we brought him a radio, because apparently his old radio had been stolen sometime after Katrina. And so he was just really happy that he had something to listen to and to do while he was sitting on the porch instead of just sitting there. But he was really fun, and I think we all learned a lot from him and had fun getting to know him.
He sits alone and broken-hearted in the corner of the church, trying to change the fallen world with his words and with his wisdom, but it seems is only getting worse. And he cries, oh Lord, I just don't understand. Then he felt the hand of grace, and he heard a voice that said, I have been there. I know what pain is all about. Yes, old man up on a hill, holding flowers, but he can't hold back the tears. Oh, he has come to say goodbye. Thinks about the life she lived, thinks about